Tonight, the Senate has passed a real property tax cap. This is final passage of the two houses and marks a historic first for New York State. There's no bigger issue on Long Island than the property tax, and capping its rate of increase is the most important thing for both the residents who own homes and the businesses who need to have a stable future for their property taxes. It limits the tax levy growth to 2% of the annual increase in the consumer price index, with some exceptions, basically emergencies. This is a significant step that the state has taken, and property owners will be appreciative in the near future. The question arises, how does the property tax cap actually work? Well, the basic mechanism is that it caps the tax levy at 2% per year. There's some exceptions to the cap. Capital expenditures, changes in growth in the district, a big tort judgment in excess of 5% of the prior year's levy, and it also excludes pension growth if the pension growth is greater than 2%. And then there are mechanisms for going above the cap if there's a vote of 60% or more, and that's been proposed by the government. In other words, it's a very narrow exception and will provide a significant change from the way business has been done by governments and local school districts in the past decade.